Shalom, shalom. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam. Blessed is the Lord our God, King of the heavens and the earth. Amen. Yeshua, Jesus, is Lord. He is the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the ending, who was and is to come, the Lord God Almighty. Yeshua, Jesus, the Messiah. Amen. That's according to Isaiah 9, verse 6, Micah 5, verse 2, Revelations 1, John chapter 1, and Colossians chapter 1. They all speak of Jesus as God in the flesh, as God Almighty. Amen. I believe the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the three are one, according to John chapter 14 and 1 John 5, verse 7 in the King James Bible. I do believe that God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself, 2 Corinthians 5:19, and that Christ died for our sins on the cross according to the scriptures. He rose again on the third day and ascended to heaven to sit at the right hand of the Father in glory. Amen. Now today I wanted to do a decode video, or at least my interpretation of what this music video is, by Taylor Swift, titled Bejeweled. Okay, it has been increasingly more difficult to make these videos recently, as the spiritual warfare is increasing because Satan knows that his time is short. Okay, now with that said, let's take a look at this video by Taylor Swift titled Bejeweled.
Your best work. That's disgusting. No, I'm sorry, my dudes. He's gonna choose me. I even contoured my abs with the mud from the hog pen outside. So.
Now here we see that Taylor Swift is a suffering servant. Okay, she's basically Cinderella. And her evil stepsisters are bragging about how they're going to this big ball, this big dance, or whatever it is, and they're going to try to win over the king. All right. Now, in my personal opinion, this seems to be somewhat of an allegory of Christ and his bride. Now, we obviously know that Christ came to deliver those who are of a broken spirit, those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake. Okay, so Christ came for those who are the downcast and the suffering. That basically is the bride of Christ. Okay, and Christ has redeemed them from this corrupt world, as the world hates his bride. Okay, just like the stepsisters hate Cinderella. Now Cinderella, I believe, is a representation of the last days church, in which will be transformed at midnight and be taken to a ball, a wedding ceremony in heaven. Okay, where Christ will marry his bride. Now this is a little bit different in the fact that Cinderella is going to this ball. She is transformed at midnight and taken to this king's palace. Okay, and she doesn't know him, or at least she hasn't seen him face to face. Okay, very similar to how the bride has not seen Christ face to face. So it's some very interesting parallels. Now I'm in no way saying that Cinderella is a Christian story, but I think some elements from the movies and the storybooks of Cinderella are pretty much borrowed from Christ, or at least inspired by the story of Christ and his bride. Okay, let's take a look at a few pictures. Now, here we see in Matthew 25, that the bridegroom is coming for the five wise virgins. Okay, it says, and while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they They that were ready went in with him to the marriage, and the door was shut. Okay, so in Matthew 25 is a parable about Christ coming to get his bride. I think it's talking about the rapture, and it's, you know, it's at midnight. Okay, so the five wise virgins go out at midnight. They are transformed into their heavenly bodies. Okay, 1 Corinthians 15 says that in, or 1 Corinthians 15 verse 52 more specifically says that, you know, in a twinkling of an eye, in a moment, okay, the dead in Christ shall rise first, and those who are alive and remain shall be taken up to be with the Lord forever. That's sort of paraphrasing, but it's a sudden transformation, just as Cinderella was transformed and taken to the dance or the ball or the dinner in heaven. Okay, so here we see in Revelations 19, Christ, you know, basically is with his church, his bride, in heaven. Okay, I believe that's after the rapture at midnight, Matthew 25, where Christ takes the five wise virgins who have oil in their lamps, takes them up to the wedding supper. Okay, and it says Revelations 19 verses 7 through 8, let us be glad and rejoice and give honor to him, for the marriage of the Lamb is come, and his wife has made herself ready. And to her was granted that she should be arrayed in fine linen, clean and white, for the fine linen is the righteousness of the saints. Okay, very interesting. And we can conclude that in Revelations 19, it shows us that the saints go from the marriage supper of the Lamb in heaven to the return of Christ at the Battle of Armageddon. Okay, this means that the rapture must take place before the second coming. Okay, if the saints return with Christ, you know, after the tribulation, Matthew 24, then we know that the saints first have to receive their glorified bodies. They must be transformed into their heavenly attire so that they could be with Christ at his return. Now, this is something I put together a while ago, but you know, it's very interesting that we're seeing this sort of theme come up with, Taylor Swift in this very popular music video. Now, I said here at midnight, Cinderella, who was a humble servant, was hated by her family. She was transformed into a beautiful bride and taken in a chariot to a wedding with a great prince. Okay, sounds familiar? Yeah. Just read Matthew 25, 1 Corinthians 15, 52, and Revelations 19. Okay, very interesting. Now let's go back to the video. So here we see, okay, this is the beginning of the music video. Taylor Swift is, you know, having to clean up after her evil stepsisters. Okay, just like, you know, the bride of Christ, the five wise virgins, they are hated in this world. They are suffering in this life for the sake of Christ, for the sake of righteousness. Okay, let's continue.
So, well, I bought diamond nipple tassels, so...
Well, I'll be poisoning all the other maidens in the village.
Oh, yes, yes, Mom!
Yes, Mommy!
Yes, Mom!
But they're changing it this year. So instead of just showing up at the ball looking hot, you have to enter a talent competition. And if you win, you get the keys to your own castle and a marriage proposal from the prince.
I simply adore a proposal. The single most defining thing a lady could hope to achieve in her lifetime. The prize of all prizes. Look how many mommies received.
Well, we all know who's not coming tonight. That weasel down there cleaning up my sick from last night.
You must clean my bedpot next.
We honestly have to do this entire verbal abuse thing every time you leave the house.
Shut up, wench!
Stop it!
You smell! No.
Okay, you know, this reminds me of how the global elite think that they're gonna have the earth, that they're gonna inherit the earth, and that, you know, the lowly Christians are just foolish and that they will never reign and rule the earth. But on the contrary, actually, Christ will exalt his bride so that his bride will reign and rule with him after the global elite and the kings of the earth are destroyed. Okay, that's in Psalms chapter 2, Revelations 19, Zechariah 14, and even the book of Enoch makes mention of this. Okay, let us continue.
Nobody cares.
Speak not, tired, tacky wench. Clean. Ugh, ladies, worry not. Even if she were allowed to go, which she is not, the prince would never have anything to do with that little harlot again. He tired of her quite quickly, didn't he? Or should I say swiftly?
There it is. There it is. That joke never gets old. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Lest we forget, you've been exiled here. You're not going anywhere anytime soon. Certainly not the ball.
Now, in this video, I think it's making a transition, okay, from talking about or emulating the Bride of Christ. Okay, now I think it's talking about Lucifer being exiled from heaven, okay? Now, when Lucifer was exiled from heaven, he was cast down to the earth, okay? I think to a degree he was taken from his glory. He was stripped from his royal adornments in heaven. Okay, let's take a look at that in the Bible. Okay. But before we take a look at that in the scripture, I just want to make a connection here with the title of the video, which is Bejeweled. Okay, and if you look up the definition for Bejeweled, it means to be adorned with jewels. Okay, so it's talking about, you know, the story of the music video is about, you know, this lowly bride being exalted and covered with jewels. Okay, now again, we know that Satan was once covered with jewels, and let's read about that in Ezekiel 28. Son of man, take up lamentation upon the king of Tyrus, that's the king of the Phoenicians, and say unto him, thus saith the Lord God, thou sealest up the sum full of wisdom and perfect in beauty. Thou hast been in Eden, the garden of God. Every precious stone was thy covering. The sardis, the topaz, the diamond, the beryl, the onyx, the jasper, the sapphire, the emerald, and the carbuncle, and even gold. The workmanship of thy tabrets and of thy pipes was prepared in thee in the day that thou was created. Okay, so here we see that, you know, this is a word from Ezekiel, the prophet of Israel, to the king of Tyrus. Okay, now this isn't talking about the king of Tyrus. This is talking about the spirit of Lucifer that was working through the king of Tyrus. It says here, you know, thou hast been in Eden, the garden of God. Well, how could King Tyrus be in Eden? Okay, he wasn't old enough, you know, to be there with Adam and Eve. Okay, and then it further concludes this with, or more or less confirms this, with Ezekiel 28:14, thou art the anointed cherub that covereth. Okay, so this here, you know, confirms that this is talking about Satan, Lucifer, the fallen cherubim, the fallen angel, who is a covering angel in the throne room of Yahweh. Okay, and it says, I have set thee so, thou was upon the holy mountain of God. Thou hast walked up and down in the midst of the stones of fire. Thou was perfect in thy ways from the day that thou was created, till iniquity was found in thee. By the multitude of thy merchandise they have filled the midst of thee with violence, and thou hast sinned. Therefore I will cast thee as profane out of the mountain of God, and I will destroy thee, O covering cherub, from the midst of the stones of fire. Then it talks about, you know, what was the sin of Lucifer? It says in Ezekiel 28:17, thine heart was lifted up because of thy beauty. Thou hast corrupted thy wisdom by reason of thy brightness. I will cast thee to the ground. I will lay thee before kings that they may behold thee. Okay, so this is again talking about Satan, you know, being kicked out of heaven. He was the anointed cherub who was covered in all these precious stones. He was beautiful and perfect until he sinned. And then it says that, you know, God was going to cast him to the ground and lay him before kings. Now, it further says in Ezekiel 28:18, thou hast defiled thy sanctuaries by the multitude of thine iniquities. By the iniquity of thy traffic, therefore will I bring forth a fire from the midst of thee, it shall devour thee, and I will bring thee to ashes upon the earth in the sight of all them that behold thee. Okay. Now we know when Christ returns in Revelations 19 and 20 that Christ will destroy the Antichrist and the false prophet at the Battle of Armageddon. And then Christ and his angels will bind Satan and cast him into the pit for 1,000 years while Christ and his bride reign and rule the earth with a rod of iron, okay, all the nations for the millennial kingdom. Now we also see this is found in Isaiah 14 as well in verses 12 to 13. It says, how art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations? For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. Okay, so I believe that Satan, Lucifer, is still seeking to make his throne in heaven. Okay, and I think he's going to try to do that at the Battle of Armageddon, where Satan and the fallen ones and the Antichrist make war against Christ at his return. I think Satan wants to destroy Christ and then take the kingdom of heaven for himself. Okay. Now, I think this is somewhat hinted at in the Taylor Swift video. But before we go back to the video, I wanted to make another note. Now, Satan is often worshipped as an androgynous being, that is both male and female, okay? We see that with the Baphomet goat god. So therefore, Taylor Swift, being a woman, could also be a physical representation of the fallen angel Lucifer. Now, let's watch how it goes from the transition of the exiled, lowly servant into this, you know, very dressed up, very adorned sort of bride. Okay, let's continue.
Now, girls,
let's get many, many children.
Oh, yes. Bye. Bye, snake.
Have fun being exiled, stinky.
I'm gonna be hungover. I'm gonna drink a...
That's interesting how they called her snake. Is that, you know, a subtle clue that this is talking about the serpent, you know, who thinks he's going to go back to heaven and to receive his jewels that he once had. Okay, let's continue.
Baby love, I think I've been a little too kind. Didn't notice you walking all over my peace of mind. And the shoes I gave you as a present. Putting someone first only works when you're in their top five.
Okay, so now we see that she looks at the clock. It's midnight. Okay, speaking of the tribulation period, Daniel 70th week. And it says the exile ends. So, okay, I think this is saying that Satan thinks that he's now going to take back the kingdom of heaven for himself and to exalt his throne above the Most High. Okay, let's continue.
And by the way, I'm going out tonight.
Okay, so now you have, you know, she's dressed up, I don't know, kind of like a Satanist or something. Okay, she's in this black gown. She has all these jewels. Alright, so again, I think talking about Lucifer when he was in heaven. And, you know, what's interesting is that there's other songs, you know, by Rihanna and I think the Beatles about Lucy in the sky with diamonds. And Rihanna sings a song about, you know, shine bright like a diamond. So I think this is talking about the glory of the angels. Okay, now when you look up in the star, in the sky, you see the stars shining brightly. They're like twinkling like a diamond in the sky. Okay, so I think when they're talking about shining like a diamond and Lucia in the sky with the diamonds, okay, I think that's talking about Lucifer and his fallen angels and their glory. Alright, that's what I think is being hinted at. So I think this is talking about a glorification of Lucifer after he tries to defeat Christ at his return. In the room, I can still make the whole place shimmer. And when I meet the band, they ask, do you have a man? I can still say I don't remember. Familiarity breeds contempt, so... Alright, I just got the Holy Spirit goosebumps. Okay, so take a listen to that again. She talks about how she could still make the whole place shine. Okay, I think that's talking about Lucifer, talking about his glory that he once had. And then it shows her going up the tower, going up the elevator on a tower. Okay, this is talking about Satan trying to ascend to heaven to make his throne above the Most High. So there you see Taylor Swift, aka Lucifer, Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds, okay, is taking the elevator up to the top. What do you see at the top? Okay, that's God's house. Alright, you know, talking about Satan going up to God's house to take the kingdom. Alright. Familiarity breeds contempt, so put me in the basement when I want the penthouse of your heart. Baby boy, I think I've been too good of a girl. Okay, so I mean, doesn't this just scream Ezekiel 28? You know, Lucifer being adorned with every precious stone. Okay, I mean, that's what I'm getting from this, alright? Now, I'm not sure if I want to show much more of the video because it shows Taylor Swift in some very indecent outfits with some other women. And, you know, I just don't think it's good to look at those sort of indecent exposures, to put it lightly. Okay, but let's just watch a little bit more. So here we see Taylor Swift goes into the highest room of the tower, okay? And it's like all the jewels are coming back to her outfit, okay? It's like Lucifer regaining his glory that he once had in heaven, as, you know, Ezekiel 28 says, you know, Lucifer was adorned with every precious stone. And what do we see here? Taylor Swift is getting her stones back. All right, let's take a look. Extra credit then got great and on a curve. I think it's time to teach some lessons. I made you my world. Have you heard how I can reclaim the land? And I miss you. She said she could reclaim the land. Okay, is that talking about Lucifer taking back the kingdom for himself? I think that's what that's talking about, okay? Okay, and that's as far as I want to go with the indecent outfits. Okay, let's see if I can find anything else at the end of the video. And then it talks about Prince Jack was forced to propose to the house wench Taylor. I don't know what this is about. I mean, that's kind of weird. Why was the prince forced to propose to the house wench Taylor? You know, is that talking about Satan, you know, forcing his dominion over Christ? Is that what that's talking about? Possibly. Okay, and then you see here Taylor is given the key. Is that talking about the key of the kingdom of heaven? you know, Satan taking the key from Jesus, who has the key over death and hell and life and everything. Okay, let's continue. You know, it tells us now that Taylor Swift has kept the castle. So it's talking about Taylor Swift just goes to this ball. Okay, goes to this, you know, sort of party in heaven. Sounds like the wedding supper of the Lamb. And that she, you know, basically takes over, okay, and takes the kingdom and the castle for herself. Okay, I think this is talking about Lucifer, you know, taking over the kingdom of God in heaven. And I think it's pretty clear. Now, if you look at her little jewelry here that's in her hair, it says TS. Okay, you might say that's Taylor Swift. You might say it could be also alluding to the serpent. Okay, TS the serpent. All right. And then what do you have? The kingdom of heaven is now taken over by a bunch of dragons. Okay, and who is the dragon? Well, Revelations 12 tells us that Satan, Lucifer, the old serpent, he is the dragon. Okay, so I think it's pretty clear, in my opinion, what this music video is about. Okay, now I wanted to show one more interesting clip that is separate from this Taylor Swift video, but I think it adds weight to my decode, to my argument concerning this video. Okay, now this is something totally separate. It's called The Dragon Prince. I think it's a show on Netflix or something, and this episode is called The Fallen Star. Okay, and it talks about the fallen star is basically a bad person who has been influencing the kings of the earth to do evil, to bring chaos. Okay, if that doesn't scream Ezekiel 28 and Isaiah 14 regarding Satan, you know, basically working through the kings of the earth, you know, I don't know what does. Okay, let's watch this clip here.
The archdragons trusted this wise and kind leader and agreed to abide by whatsoever she decided. But before she could bring peace to the world, Queen Aditi went missing. Chaos and confusion erupted, and war threatened to tear Zadia apart, as now the elves suspect the dragons had killed their queen. But truth came from an unexpected source. A young human girl uncovered a great secret of history. A dangerous deceiver was revealed. It was one of the great ones, the Star Touch elf, Erebos. For 1,000 years, Erebos had been pulling invisible strings like a puppet master. Every great crisis the world faced seemed the work of some ingenious and powerful leader. But in each case, it was secretly Erebos whispering in their ear.
Okay, so there in this show, okay, titled The Dragon Prince, and the episode The Fallen Star, okay, it's basically telling us this fallen star, Erebos, has been the one that's been behind all of the chaos and violence and destruction upon the earth. Okay, and that's basically Isaiah 14. If you read Isaiah 14, it talks about Lucifer, you know, corrupting the kings of the earth, you know, bringing the nations to destruction, Okay, and we obviously read from Ezekiel 28 that Satan was working through the king of Tyrus. Alright, so it's very clear to me this fallen star is talking about Lucifer, the fallen angel. Okay, stars are angels in the Bible. Okay, so just to read this one more time, Isaiah 14, verses 12 to 13. How art thou fallen from heaven? Okay, the fallen star. O Lucifer, son of the morning, how art thou cut down to the ground, which did weakest the nations? For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. Okay, Satan wants to take the kingdom of heaven for himself. And he's been working through the kings of the earth to destroy the nations because, you know, he doesn't like mankind. Okay, so here we see Saturn's cube in reference to Saturn the star. Okay, Saturn being Satan. And Saturn's star is supposed to be black or dark. And, you know, that's a reference to a star who loses his light, okay? That's because Satan fell from heaven. And when Satan the star fell from heaven, he lost his light. And now his cube is supposed to represent his kingdom on the earth. And in Luke chapter 4, verses 5 through 7, it tells us that the devil offered Jesus all the kingdoms of the world if Jesus would worship him, okay? But of course, that did not happen, okay? Because Christ is God, amen. And here we see that all these, you know, entertainers and high-ranking people, they're all throwing up Satan's pyramid, Satan's all-seeing eye pyramid. Okay, they all worshiped Lucifer, the fallen star. Okay. In the 2 Corinthians 4, verses 3 to 4, it says, but if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world has blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. Okay, so this says that Satan is the God of this world. And we see that because all the entertainers and high-ranking people, they do the all-seeing eye, they do the one-eyed shepherd symbolism in homage to Lucifer, their God. And in Revelations 12, verse 9, it says, and the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. Okay, I believe that will happen very soon with the rise of the Antichrist. And Satan will no longer be able to go before the throne room of God in heaven. Anyhow, I pray this video was a blessing. I believe time is very short and the rapture is very soon. So let us all repent, turn away from our sins, follow Jesus, Yeshua, according to the scriptures. And watch and pray always that we are counted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man, according to Luke 21, verse 36. And shalom, until next time. Amen.